Here's what you missed on Phathead and Cande in the morning. Weekdays 6 to 10 a.m. on My Country 96.1.
My Country 96.1, Phathead, Cande Roth. We're looking at a decent day, 70 to 72. I'll tell you, in certain spots, could hit 75, mix of sun and clouds. There could be a storm later, but, I mean, we're going to have a great time. Salt Shack, Cedar Beach, and Babylon. Looks like it's going to be great, perfect. Southbound performs, and we are so excited for another big night out, Cande. So everyone,
of course, it's going to be great, but the weather seems to be forgot it's June and jumped right to August.
It's crazy like that. Yes, I
it
agree
is.
With you.
It was a crazy weather weekend.
Yeah. Cande, I've been really wanting to read this story to you because I know how much you love your true crime shows, you know?
Love. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So there's a new job listing at the Tucson, Arizona Police Department. If you ever want to be a detective, but not a police officer, now's your chance. They are hiring 20 people with the job title Professional Staff Investigator.
Ooh.
And here's what happens, okay? There's a little bit of training. You do go through 7 weeks at a police academy, and then you do 3 months of field training. But the catch is, you don't carry a gun, okay? There's no gun. You don't have to be trained with a gun. You can't be the first person to the scene of a crime. You can never be first. You got to wait till someone else from the department gets there. And you can't arrest anyone. So technically, you're still a civilian. But here's what you can do. You can investigate for the Tucson Police Department anything that involves crime scene management, forensics, public safety, or loss prevention, and they're going to pay these 20 people up to $33 an hour for this job.
I think that's the smartest thing I've heard a police department do in some time. And it's funny you're telling me that story now because I was watching this murder story yesterday. And this woman, her husband went to jail and she knew he was innocent. And they just, she had to go and be the detective and the investigator. And after 7.5 years, she proved the case. He was in jail for 7.5 years. If it wasn't for her and all of her discovery and all the things she did, he'd still be in jail.
Well, you make a good point. And that's, I think, what the Tucson Police Department is trying to do. Now, make no mistake. I know it sounds like a joke, but you cannot carry a gun. You're not a police officer. You can't roll up to the scene of a crime and try to arrest someone. You're just kind of an add-on and basically an extra set of hands and eyes to go do what you said, to sit in front of a computer and Google stuff, or maybe they can send you out to go, interview some people to get a little more information on a subject or something, or what might have been going on at the scene of a crime. So you don't have the responsibility of an officer, but you're paid to be in the department and live out your fantasy, Cande.
I love it.
Yes.
And regular people sometimes are a bit better at doing this type of thing.
Yes. And
police have their handful. They've
correct.
Got the paperwork. They've got the follow-ups. They've got this, that, and the other thing. But a regular old person, they get right down to the meat of the matter.
You can dedicate a little time.
I think it's a fabulous idea. Yeah,
you can dedicate more time to it. My sister Amy and you could share an apartment. The two of
we
you
could.
Move.
We could. She can make me macaroons as I'm on the phone investigating.
There you go. The two of you would be fantastic. A regular Cagney and Lacey, you two kids.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Would be unbelievable. So, all right. So you're into it. You want the job. Yes?
I think it's a great idea. I really do.
All right.
I'm not moving to Tucson, but if it were here, perhaps I'd give it a go.
I understand. Cande, it is International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking.
Every day is that day for me.
We can agree on that. It's also the International Day in Support of Victims of Torture. I suppose.
Oh, goodness.
Get behind that as well.
Wow.
It's National Barcode Day. I was watching a special on History Channel, The Foods That Made America.
I've seen that from time to time. That's a good show.
they talk about the invention of the barcode and what it did to the supermarket industry and everything. It is National Barcode Day. I mean, it changed the way we purchase food and items, Cande.
Everything. Everything. Yeah. Yep, it really did.
It is National Coconut Day. Are you a fan?
I do love coconut. Yes, I do.
All right. It is National Chocolate Pudding Day today.
Throw some toasted coconut on top, and you got a little fancy dessert there.
You like with the skin on top?
I love the skin. My mother used to try to stop the skin from forming. I'd be like, are you crazy, lady? Are you crazy?
And finally, it is National Beautician's Day. How do you feel about your beautician?
I love her.
Yeah?
No, I love her.
She does a great job for you. Okay.
She does a great job. We work together. You know, these things take time to get the actual perfect haircut or what you're looking for. So we've been at it, and now we're in a good place together. Her mother... Yeah. Just died at 102 years old.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Bless her. Yeah. Oh, my
yeah.
God.
Mm-hmm. No, that's I love incredible. Sandy. Sandy's her name. My hairdresser. Love her.
Sandy.
Hey, Sandy. Love you, girl.
Oh, Sandy. Keep making Cande beautiful. Wonderful.
Yes.
All right. Cande, Jiffy Lube wants to make sure you can get your ice cream fixed this summer by keeping ice cream trucks on the road. They're offering $150 vouchers for free maintenance to all ice cream trucks in the U.S. How about that?
Wow. They really want to keep it going.
I love that. People are calling this the smartest cow in the world.
Oh.
A cow in Nebraska, the name is Ghost, just set a world record by doing 10 tricks in under a minute, like stay, spin, kiss, answers yes with a head nod, and... She does fist bumps, Cande.
I've never seen about or heard about a smarter cow.
Yeah, I can't imagine trying to train the cow to do all those things.
That's quite impressive.
And firefighters in Florida saved a horse that decided to jump into an above-ground swimming pool last week. Mm. It got on its owner's deck, jumped in. They couldn't get it out. They had to use heavy machinery to hoist it up. And the horse is fine. They got
I'm glad to hear that. Happy ending. That's the way we like it.
Absolutely. I want you to have a great rest of your day, Cande, please.
I'm going to try.
Yeah. Don't think too much about the story we talked about earlier. By the way, if you're just joining us, at about noon, we will have the full show up for a playback at licountry.com on our website. And you have to listen to the segment where Cande feels a little betrayed by her son.
I wouldn't say betrayed. I would say, all right, betrayed. Not lied to, just not informed.
Right. She was not the babysitter for Maeve, the granddaughter.
This is the first time
And
they've ever left her.
Yeah, she wasn't really told about the event going on either, so... We'll see how this one plays out. I'm interested. But I tell you, your granddaughter is the gift that keeps on giving to this show, Cande. And I want to thank you for that. Thank you. Okay?
I don't know if I'm taking that as a compliment.
Yeah. No, it's a compliment. It's good.
I've about had it with you. I think it's time to say goodbye.
Have a great day. 70 to 75 today. Mix of sun and clouds. We'll have a big night at Salt Shack, Cedar Beach in Babylon. Let's hit the roads. My country, 96.1.
Phathead and Cande in the morning. Weekdays, 6 to 10 a.m. on My Country, 96.1.